Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Rohit from REC. We are better known as REC Solar in Europe and other parts of the world. So there's always a confusion about REC being Rural Electrification Corporation. And I also studied at an REC Regional Engineering College. So it took me 14 years and I'm back to square one. So anyway, they are coming to the agenda. I think we are talking, the session is focused on technology, and I'll be very brief about why REC, comes in, hands in glove with technology. Like to give a brief introduction, we are a 20-year-old company, fully integrated player. Starting from polysilicon to solar module manufacturing, we do everything in-house. We have two key locations for manufacturing. One is Norway, where we do our polysilicon manufacturing and a wafer block line, which is about a gigawatt. And the second location is Singapore, which is again starting from where we get in the polysilicon into Singapore, and we do the wafer block slicing and cells and modules there. Now, if you look at any industry, there are basically two approaches to the industry. One is you become either a technology player or you scale up on volume to compete. So if you go the China way, it's gigawatts and gigawatts in solar. The smallest player there might be talking about a gigawatt, and the biggest is 9 gigawatt. So if you're from Trina, I know I'm not holding back there. I'm not wrong about that. There are two approaches here. Now REC takes a technology approach, and I have been with REC for 5 years. When I joined REC in 2012. We were manufacturing modules of 225, 230, 240 watt modules. And what we are offering today is 345, 350 watt as a standard product in a 72 cell, and up to 295 watt in a 60 cell configuration. Now, the key point here is we are still on a multi-crystalline, or a polysilicon platform. And we are achieving watt classes almost equivalent to mono PERC and better than mono. So now from a technology perspective again, I think we should look at being a technology agnostic. Sujay just spoke about First Solar. They are again one of the technology leaders with a different material. And you have Solar Frontier in Japan. So there are many companies sitting in different parts of the world, and there are many companies in China also. They are doing a fantastic job today. Now, how different REC here is, what we offer to the end customer at the end of it is, if you look at what are we doing with the solar module, we are generating energy. So, the key is how much are you generating and how much are you paying for it. If you look at REC power plants anywhere in the world today, I'll talk more about India because I have, we are more focused on the Indian market, but the lowest, performance ratio we have seen with our plants is 82%. A well-engineered and a well-managed power plant, we have seen, even for a rooftop installation, we have seen 82%, and for a single-axis tracker based, it has gone beyond 84%. Now, this, this in short talks about what we deliver to our customer, and the second part is basically the reliability aspect. Reliability is basically, we have a global, warranty claim rate less than 50 parts per million. And I take pride to say that in India, it's even better. I have never had a backsheet complaint. We have probably almost maybe 70, 80% of the manufacturers in India have faced backsheet complaints, or maybe all. You don't have the data, but yeah. So for REC, I can say we have never seen a backsheet failure in India. We have never seen a PID failure with REC modules. You don't need to negative ground your inverter when you're using REC modules. Now, if it comes to rooftop installations, you're using string inverters which are isolation based. They're not using isolation transformers. So you actually have to spend more money to get a separate equipment from the inverter manufacturer if it is available, and then do a negative grounding. With REC modules, you get 100% warranty without using negative grounding solution here. So, another factor I'll talk about reliability, this is basically on low warranty claims. Then we talk about degradation. While we offer the same warranty as most of our competitors, We actually have been, we go beyond manufacturing. We, as most of the technology leaders would be doing, we have brought in modules from the field, tested them at third-party accredited labs. And, for a Rajasthan location, we had a 3.5-year-old installation, and the actual degradation over 3.5 years for five modules was just 0.68%. So this is the kind of, degradation we talk about, and this comes with 100% consistency in manufacturing. We have imported over 200 megawatt of modules into India till date, which is fairly small as compared to, a lot of our counterparts. But considering the premium positioning we have, this is a very decent number. We are probably the largest module manufacturer in India with a European lineage. So I can say that except for two customers, nobody has ever been to our factory for a pre-dispatch inspection. We have had many customers who have come to our factory just to visit our facility, but nobody has even come and done a random testing of our modules. So that is the kind of consistency we, bring about here. So this is just a gist about REC. We have a good setup in India. There are a lot of interesting, discussions. Someone, gentleman here mentioned, do we have the manpower, right? So now these are things which we cannot change overnight. It takes time. So that was one of the key things which I did when I took over the Indian operations for REC. Instead of starting off with sales, the first person I brought into my team was a technical person. The key here is basically, there are hundreds of new players coming into solar. And especially if you look at the rooftop segment, in utility scale, when you have a target to do 200, 500, a gigawatt of installations, you can scale up on the manpower, you can bring in the skill sets, you can send them abroad for training, you can do a lot of things. But look at the people who are, small EPC players, installers who are doing a 5 kilowatt, a 10 kilowatt, a 100 kilowatt, a 200 kilowatt, absolute startup. So this is where we come in. We work with the partners. We have a global program which is called the REC Professional Program. We train the partners, we handhold them, we do site audits. So today I have two technical guys in my team and just three sales guys. And we have partners who have been with us for 5 years. Even if they do maybe 200 kilowatt a year or five, maybe a megawatt a year, they just sell REC. And the customers they have sold to, they only buy REC. And they have been with us for, my first customer was February 2012. And this customer is still with me. And I have sold 5.5 megawatt to him in 5 years, and I'm going to get a 5 megawatt order in the next 30 days or 40 days. And there will be no competition there. So that's the kind of way we work in the Indian market. We also adopt the same ways, quite similar to what, Sujay was mentioning. We do rolling reliability tests, we pick out random modules. When we develop our product, we work at twice the IEC standards. And when we talk about innovation, we have been at the not just at the when you talk about efficiency, we have been one of the industry leaders. We have also brought down the temperature coefficient of polysilicon to newest levels. We are at minus 0.36, which is one of the best. We are the first company to commercialize poly PERC modules. Mono PERC modules have been available for a very long time. We launched our first poly PERC module in January 2015. We are within 18 months, we launched the third generation of that product. And I can assure you, our product development team is working on, many other products. Like in the 12-month window, the product development team developed 27 types of modules. So that is the, there's a huge amount of money which goes in. We collaborate with CERIS in Singapore. We work with university in Australia. So there is a huge amount of effort on that side. And so if you start, if it so just to summarize, if you look at it from starting from polysilicon to our interface with the customer, be it our EPC partners or our developer partners or the end customer, we work very closely. We understand the whole cycle of this business, and we are evolving every day. It's not that, we know everything. Every day is a learning day. We learn something new, we evolve, and get better. Thank you so much.
Thank you.